brutal acts. How does that constitute reform?
Good morning, Rosemary. It's raining cats and dogs here in Lagos, and that's the same question that protesters are asking, and they are demanding answers to say that they want more accountability, and they are still marching, even in the rain. This downpour is not going to dampen the demands or the mood of this activism, they say. They want the Inspector General to resign. They're calling for his resignation. They're saying that his men are clearly not listening to him because that we are seeing acts of police brutality, police opening live ammunition on protesters demonstrating peacefully. And they're also saying, why is this unit set up so quickly without any consultation? And why are the officers from this unit, from the former unit, going to be part of this? For its part, the IGP, the Inspector General, says these men are going to, and women are going to be retrained and given medical examinations and psychological tests to ensure that they fit to be part of this new unit. But, you know, the protesters are calling for more accountability about the police brutality that we've seen.
And Stephanie, in contrast to the police brutality, protesters have been peaceful. What have you witnessed on the ground there, and what have victims been telling you?
Yes, one of the victims we spoke to was arrested along with another female protester, and she told us that she was beaten very, very severely during the arrest, and she's shown us some very graphic images of the bruises and the wounds that she developed after this arrest. But in contrast to these images of brutality, frankly, what we're seeing on the ground is peaceful protest, a sense of camaraderie. The protesters are even cleaning up their trash. That's what we witnessed out on the streets here in Lagos at the protest sites that we've been to. They've organized medical help, lawyers to bail out arrested protesters. And so really what we're seeing is in contrast to the police response, which has been in most parts brute force, Rosemary.
Stephanie Bazzari in Lagos, many thanks for bringing us up to date on this very important story. And for more on this,